Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Pharmacypedia. In this video, we are going to discuss further about another building blocks of cosmetics, that are antimicrobials. Antimicrobials are part of each and every cosmetics. Since antimicrobials are basically added up to the product formulations to maintain the microbiological safety of the products, to inhibit the growth of microorganisms and reducing the amount of the total microbial contaminants. So these are the substances which are added up to keep the microbial load of the cosmetic formulation to lower extent, because these are the microbials are the causes of contaminations. They are not at all desired in any of the cosmetics. So it is very important to keep the microbial load to the minimum for its beneficial actions. So antimicrobials are the desired constituents which are added up to any cosmetics to reduce the microbiological load, to inhibit the growth of microorganisms so that the formulation remains stable and viable. So let us try to understand the microbial preservatives which are being added into the various different type of the cosmetic formulations. There are large number of preservatives which are being added up and used. We are here to discuss few of the preservatives which are mostly in major amount added up to the cosmetic formulations. The very first example belongs to the category of the parabens. Now parabens like methyl parabens, propyl parabens, butyl parabens, they are vastly used in cosmetics because they are very economical. They are most widely used group of preservatives in the cosmetics. They are found to be effective in various types of prevention like fungal protection and some gram positive bacteria too. They are sometimes combined with other forms to have the both reduction, gram positive as well as the gram negative protection. They are sometimes allowed for both the rinse off and the leave on the products, for example detergents, etc., shampoos, etc. So there, but in my video, I have discussed that parabens lies into the category of the controversial products. They have certain side effects as well. They are linked to various harmful diseases, and it was concluded that they were safer for using cosmetics up to a certain level, up to 25%. Typically, parabens are used in the levels ranging from 0.01 to 0.3%. So their use is being restricted to a limited extent. If they are used beyond that concentration, they are found to have harmful effects, like they are linked to the cancers as well. So next category comes that are the formaldehyde releases. Again, they are widely used into cosmetics like nail lacquers. Examples of formaldehydes include like DMDM, hydantoin. They are effective for bacteria, weak fungal efficacy, and they releases formaldehyde as needed to maintain low levels. So you must have seen that peculiar smell. They are into the gaseous forms. They continuously release from the products. The use of formaldehyde releasing preservatives ensures that the actual level of the free formaldehyde in the product is always very low, yet sufficient to ensure the microbial inhibition. So again, they lie also into the category of the controversial ingredients because of their gaseous nature, and they are being released slowly from the products. The next preservatives widely used into cosmetics are isothiazolinones. The examples like ethone, they lie into the category of the broad spectrum because of their effectiveness. They are best for the rinse of products like shampoos. They are effective over the entire pH range normally encountered in the cosmetics. The toxicological data has also shown that they are non-carcinogenic. They are sometimes causes the skin irritations in some of the consumers. The next category of the preservatives widely used in cosmetics are the phenoxyethanols. For example, the Otifen Plus, Otifen. So they are often considered as a milder alternatives to traditional preservatives. They are not broad spectrum, but they are combined with some other sort of the preservatives like sorbic acid, potassium sorbates, or like ADT to create the broad spectrum efficacy. They have the good bacterial efficacy. The best act against the gram negative bacteria. They are found to be very stable, and they are not pH dependent. They are allowed in most areas up to 1%, though found to be non-irritating or sensitizing up to 2.2%. So So all these antimicrobials are found to have restricted use. They are found to be beneficial up to a certain extent. Their limit needs to be checked up before formulating, and they are permissible up to certain limits. Another category which lies into the antimicrobials are the various kinds of organic acids like benzoates, potassium sorbates, sodium benzoates, anisic acid. Their higher use levels to be effective leads to higher cost. They are, as compared to parabens, formaldehyde releases, they are a little bit higher side as far as the economics is concerned. Their aqueous base is required and effective against most of the fungi with weak efficacy against the bacteria. So often they are again combined with other organic acids or like other antimicrobials. They are considered to be the natural alternatives, though they are often made synthetically. They also precipitate in high water content and become no longer active. They require pH range of 2 to 6. They are found to be beneficial if the pH range rises between 2 to 6. So, as far as we have seen, that antimicrobials are generally not added singularly. They are added, in combinations to have the broad spectrum of activity. Nowadays, the trend is to have the preservative-free formulations because these preservatives are linked up with so many diseases. They are lying into the range of the controversial ingredients like parabens, formaldehyde release. So nowadays, the trend is towards the preservative-free formulations. As far as the merits of the preservatives are concerned, they are definitely helpful in preventing the contamination and the harmful growth of the bacteria in various kinds of the cosmetic preparations. Now, antimicrobial preservatives in cosmetics and personal care product also prevent the growth of other microbial content like molds, yeast, and bacteria. They guard against the contamination that can cause irritation or infections. Now, antioxidant preservatives are again very important. They can help keep the personal care products from spoiling by suppressing the reactions that can occur when certain ingredients in the cosmetic combine with the oxidant. So, the trend towards the antioxidant preservatives are very much required. Now, let us understand the factors which affects the microbial preservative efficacy. There are various factors which affects the preservative efficacy. For example, the interaction with the other formulation components, like properties of the preservatives also, effect of the container closure systems, type of the microorganisms against which the protection is being required, then the influence of the pH. Let us discuss them one by one. So, the presence of other hydrocolloids such as methyl cellulose or like alginate, tragacanth, they can interact with the preservatives and diminish their activity. Due to these interactions, the microbial efficacy, microbial action is getting reduced. Many emulsions are used in pharmaceutical preparations to produce elegant applications, but sometimes interactions may occur between the preservatives and emulsified oil base and with emulgent molecules. Now again, the nature of the oil, oil-water ratio, type of the concentration of emulgent, influence the concentration of preservatives needed to protect the system. Many tablet additives also cause problems in tablet preservations due to their interaction with other added substances. Now, the another factor which is very important is about the properties of the preservative against also plays a very critical role in assessing the preservative efficacy. Now, the distribution of the preservative must be homogeneous throughout the preparation. It should have the more solubility in the bulk phase is preferable. Some chemicals such as chlorobutyl may hydrolyze on storage if the pH is unfavorable. So the pH conditions, the properties of the pH also influences the preservative efficacy. Preservatives may then again react with the substances which are leached from the container and lose its antimicrobial activity. So again, you can understand the properties of the preservatives again play a very important role in determining the total overall antimicrobial activity. The next factor, which is again very important, is the type of the container closure system. Now, formulations packed in the glass containers are expected to retain their preservative content if the closure is airtight, because the problems associated with the plastics are more. Like preservatives may penetrate through the plastic containers due to the leaching and permeation effects and interact with it. Rubbers also react with many preservatives, but is still used for the closures part. Now, containers or closures may cause contamination of the pathogens as well. Now, screw-capped containers and corks are the common source of the mold spores. So, like container closure system also plays a critical effect in controlling the microbial efficacy. Now, the type of the microorganisms against which the desired antimicrobial activity is required is also one of the factors in understanding the preservative efficacy. For example, the plants produce many contain pathogenic microorganisms from the soil. For example, the Clostridium species or like Bacillus anthracillus. These soil microorganisms can cause spoilage of the pharmaceutical products. Many products prepared from the animal sources may also contain pathogens like Salmonella typhi. Now, the spores of the tetanus and gas gangrene have been isolated from gelatin. So, the type of the organism, whether it belongs to the spores category or like it is getting like Clostridium category or Bacillus category, also depends on what kind of the antimicrobial preservative is required, whether a combination of antimicrobials are required to have the desired sort of the action. Now, the pH is again a very important factor because each antimicrobial activity is efficacious during a particular pH range. Each antimicrobial is effective against a particular pH range. So, like the adjustment of the pH of the solution may sometimes affect the chemical stability and the activity of the preservative. If it is not lying within that range, that antimicrobial activity would be diminished. So, the majority of the pH are less dependent upon the pH, although cationic active quaternary ammonium compounds are more active at higher pH values. So, the pH again plays a very important factor in deciding the preservative efficacy. So thank you so much for watching my video. Please do like, share and subscribe Pharmacypedia. Also please provide your views in the comment box. Happy learning.